What's up, YouTubers? My name is James Kwong, entrepreneur, motivational coach, and avid stock trader. Today's video is going to be about the top 10 best investment apps for 2021. Investing is key to building your wealth, so I thought I'd share some great apps to help you get started in 2021. All right, here we go, starting with number one. Got my lucky notes here, so I don't want to miss anything. All right, so number one, we have Webull. Webull is a safe and secure brokerage that allows you to invest in stocks, ETFs, and options commission-free. It's a great platform for beginner investors due to how user-friendly their app and site is, and they're great for more advanced investors due to the number of trading tools they offer. Webull is also designed for intermediate and experienced traders with many tools that beginner traders will enjoy as well. It uses a commission-free structure that allows active and short-term traders to save a good chunk of money on commissions when compared to other online brokers. I use this myself. I have a link below in my description box. If you want to get 4 free stocks from Webull, just click that link and you can get 4 free stocks. All right, number two, I have Robinhood. This is another beginner app. A lot of people are using it today. Robinhood is an American financial services company headquartered in Menlo Park, California. The company offers a mobile app and website that offer people the ability to invest in stocks, ETFs, and options through Robinhood Financial and crypto trading through Robinhood Crypto. With free trades and no account minimums, Robinhood is easy to suggest as the best brokerage for novice investors. As long as these investors are willing to find educational resources and research tools elsewhere. You can make money with your Robinhood investments by holding stocks that pay out dividends. But remember, there's an option to reinvest those profits back into additional shares. Reinvesting dividends allows you to earn compound interest and is a great way to grow your portfolio.
This is another easy one for beginners. I also use it as well. And I also have a link in my description box if you want to get a free stock from Robinhood. Just click the link in my description box. All right, number three, I have E-Trade Financial.
E-Trade Financial Corporation is a subsidiary of Morgan Stanley. It offers an electronic trading platform to trade financial assets, including common stocks, preferred stocks, future contracts, exchange-traded funds, options, mutual funds, and fixed income investments. The founder is William A. Porter. Frequent trader who needs both mobile and online platforms, E-Trade is a good choice. Beginner investors will like E-Trade's streamlined trading platform, many zero commission trading options, and broad selection of commission-free mutual funds, which make diversification cheaper and simpler.
All right, number four on my list is TD Ameritrade.
Ameritrade is a broker that offers an electronic trading platform for the trade of financial assets, including common stocks, preferred stocks, futures contracts, exchange-traded funds, options, cryptocurrency, mutual funds, and fixed income investments. It also provides margin lending and cash management services. The CEO is Steve Boyle. Minimum to opening a new account. However, a $2,000 deposit is required to be considered for margin and certain option privileges, regardless of any promotional offer.
All right, moving on to number five.
Five, we have Sophie Invest. Sophie Invest is squared aimly at young investors with free trades of stocks, exchange-traded funds, and the ability to buy and sell cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin and Ethereum, and fractional shares of blue chip companies such as Amazon and Netflix. The self-directed brokerage is part of San Francisco company's growing line of financial products, which includes RoboAdvisor, SoFi Automated Investing, an online cash management account, SoFi Money, and gives members benefits such as educational seminars and meetings with financial advisors. SoFi has a no account minimum, but you will need cash to trade and begin buying and selling stocks and ETFs. SoFi Active Investing was among the first brokerages to offer fractional shares, buying a piece of a share rather than shelling out the full share price. That's an increasingly attractive option as the market has led to sky-high stock prices, and it offers new investors a cost-effective way to build a diversified portfolio.
This one I haven't used, but it's also very popular and some of my friends use it. All right, number six, we have Acorns. This one's very popular.
Acorns is an American financial technology and financial services company based in Irvine, California, that specializes in micro-investing and robo-investing. As of 2019, Acorns had over 4.5 million users and over 1.2 billion in assets under management. The CEO is Noah Kerner. Acorns is a great investment app. So yes, you're going to earn money from not only your investments, but also from cash back on qualifying purchases if you use their card.
I know this app is great to use when you make purchases, because when you make purchases, it'll round it up to the nearest dollar. And it'll take that amount and it'll invest in things that you want, in stocks, companies, and so forth. All right, guys, we're halfway through. Stick with me. Number seven is Fidelity.
Fidelity is an American multinational financial services corporation based in Boston, Massachusetts. The company was established in 1946 and is one of the largest asset managers in the world, with $3.3 trillion in assets under management as of June 2020 and a combined total customer asset value number of $8.3 trillion. The CEO is Abigail Johnson. Fidelity Investments operates a brokerage firm, manages a large family of mutual funds, provides fund distribution and investment advice, retirement services, index funds, wealth management, cryptocurrency, securities execution and clearance, and life insurance.
I actually have my Roth IRA with Fidelity. Fidelity won Investopedia's Best Overall Award for 2020. All right, number eight, we have Ally Invest.
Invest has competitive pricing, helping trading tools, and easy to use trading platform. With no account minimum and thousands of no transaction fee mutual funds on offer, it's easy for beginners to get started. While active investors will appreciate Ally's commission-free trades on eligible U.S. securities, Ally Invest is a trusted online brokerage with more than $4.7 billion in assets under management. It's a member of the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, FDIC, and the Securities Investor Protection Corporation, SIPC, so you can be rest assured that your cash is safe in these accounts.
All right, number nine. Charles Schwab.
Charles Schwab Corporation is an American multinational financial services company founded and based in San Francisco, California. Headquartered in the SoMa District, San Francisco, Charles Schwab is the 14th largest banking institution in the United States with over US $3.3 trillion in client assets. There aren't any fees for opening up a Schwab account or to maintain one per se, but there is a $1,000 investing minimum to start using the account. That means you can set up an account for free, but you'll need to fund it with $1,000 to do anything with it. In 2020, Charles Schwab was selected as one of the Fortune Top 50 World's Most Admired Companies. In 2020, we ranked number two overall in the securities and asset management category of the list, with a number one ranking for innovation and key attributes of reputation.
All right, we finally made it to number 10. Number 10 is Stash Financial.
Stash Financial, or simply Stash, is an American financial technology and financial services company based in New York, New York. The company operates both web platform and mobile apps, allowing users to incrementally invest small amounts. The bottom line, Stash aims to make investing approachable for beginners. The service has a zero account minimum and charges $1 to $9 a month, depending on account types. If you're looking for a little hand-holding while you build a portfolio of stocks and ETFs, Stash is a good fit. Stash is basically an investing app, not a way to make consistent income unless you're investing in stocks that pay dividends.
In other words, it's going to take money to make money with Stash. All right, those are your top 10 investment apps for 2021. I highly suggest choosing one or maybe two of those apps today to start saving and growing your portfolio today. All right, everybody, my motivational quote of the day comes from my favorite book, The Four Agreements. If you haven't read this book changed my life. I love it dearly, and I highly suggest reading it. The Four Agreements are, number one, don't take things personally. Number two, always do your best. Number three, never make assumptions. And number four, be impeccable with your word. I'm definitely going to do a video later on this and just emphasize all of this because it really, really changed my life. Once again, this channel is all about how to be an entrepreneur, grow your wealth, and just be happy. I'll be doing videos every week so you don't want to miss out. All right, everybody, you made it through the end of my video. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. I'm on my road to 1,000 subscribers. Please don't forget to get your free stocks from Webull and Robinhood in the description below. Click those links, get your free money. Once again, I'm James Kwong. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in my next video. Let's shake this Buddha for good luck again, huh? All right.